Hello, my dear students. Today I am going to explain about plastic. This is the second video of lesson 3. In my first video, I have been explained about fiber and type of fibers. And in this video, I am going to explain about plastic and what is the relation between plastic and the environment. So let me discuss. We have discussed about the definition or what is plastic. And we have also discussed about the different characteristic features of plastic and why plastic is important, how it can be neutralized, and why plastic is neutralized to make so many articles. That is because the property of the plastic. Now, we will talk about the type of plastic. We can divide the plastic into two categories. First is the thermosetting plastic and second is thermoplastic. Now, what are the characteristic features about thermoplastic? So, what is the meaning of thermoplastic? Thermoplastic are the plastic which become soft and melt on heating. That means it can be melted and molded by many times. Okay? This type of plastic melted and molded many times when we heat. And the second one is thermosetting plastic. It is the just opposite to the thermoplastic. That means it is a plastic that cannot be melted or soft on heating. So this type of plastic is known as thermosetting plastic. Now, last topic is plastic and the environment. This is the last topic of this lesson. We will talk about effects of plastic on the environment and management of plastic wastes. What are the effects of plastic on environment? Students, we know plastic is non-biodegradable material. Before this topic, we will discuss about what is biodegradable material and what are non-biodegradable material. So first is, what is the definition of biodegradable material? The material which can be decomposed by microorganisms are called biodegradable materials. Example of biodegradable materials are paper, cotton, wood, etc. And this type of material is known as non-biodegradable. Which material which cannot be decomposed by microorganism are called non-biodegradable material? Example of non-biodegradable materials are plastic, metal container, glass, etc. And all students, all are knowing plastic is a non-biodegradable material substance. It is a man-made substance. Plastic cannot be decomposed by microorganism in nature. That is why it causes soil pollution and water pollution. Now the question is, how to manage plastic waste? Students, we must follow concept of 3 R's. That is reduce, reuse and recycle. What is reduce? We can reduce the use of plastic by using other materials in their places. For example, using cloths, jute and paper bags for shopping, that is reduce. Okay. And second is, what is reuse? We should reuse the plastic container that come with them, pickles, packed food, etc. for storing salt, sugar, etc. We can also use plastic carry bag or shopping purpose. So students, my topic is completed. Bye.